across the world, there are more than 60 million health workers. As with any other population group, many among them may choose to move within countries or migrate due to personal, family, or professional reasons. Migration of a large number of healthcare workers can significantly affect health systems and service delivery. Almost 60 countries in the world currently face critical deficits in the number of health professionals. In just a few years, this deficit will reach an estimated 12.9 million workers, greatly impacting on population access to health services. The European Commission estimates that the European Union will be faced with a shortage of 1 million health professionals by 2020.
In the modern world, mobility, migration, it's inescapable. It's a choice, but it's very important that you have policies also in building your domestic system and in the context of migration itself, which avoid making migration a question of necessity, but more of choice, and also looking at the possibility of getting healthcare workers and high-level know-how back to the country, avoiding brain drain.
The health system of the Republic of Moldova has not escaped this global problem. It has been especially impacted by migration from the country, by uneven geographical distribution of professionals between rural and urban areas, and by limitations in planning and governance of human resources for health. Over the last 20 years, the Republic of Moldova has been seriously affected by the migration phenomenon that has led to brain drain and brain waste. Many health professionals trained in the Republic of Moldova have left the country, migrating mostly to European Union member states, which have benefited from the influx.
A fost nevoit să plec atunci. Și am plecat, din motivul a fost asta, că nu mă putem descurca cu salariul care îl avem. Două persoane mari de acum, necesitățile erau mai mari și de îmbrăcat și de contractul de plătit la universitate. Pur și simplu când am văzut că îs la limită, eu am plecat.
Eu am plecat într-o perioadă când în țară era mare dezastru. Și pur și simplu mi-era imposibil să lucrez căutând înainte de operație niște seringi, niște ațe de sutură și așa mai departe. Motivul care m-a făcut să rămân acolo este unul foarte simplu, adică sunt mai multe. Este un interes profesional să lucrez în condiții satisfăcătoare, adică aș spune chiar luxoase, în medicină, ceea ce pot oferi țările industrial dezvoltate. Alt motiv este cultural și nu în ultimul rând motivul material.
After long procedures in destination countries to obtain recognition of their diplomas, some health workers have integrated successfully in the health systems of their destination countries. But most work in positions lower than their qualifications.
Pe profesie nu poți să lucrezi acolo, asta e lege, fiindcă aceștia care pleacă de la noi, chiar specialiști, doctori, lucrează ca infirmiere, lucrează ca felcher, lucrează ca suror, nu, ca să lucreze ca medic, el trebuie să țină un examen, dar un examen așa care nu prea fac față toți acolo la dânsul. Și de atâta ei lucrează, și infirmiere lucrează, și diferit.
Câte diplome n-ai avea, eu deja eram, aveam și titlul științific, dar nu te primește nimeni ca medic, așa, pe cineva venit din altă țară, poți începe o carieră pe filiera aceasta de studii post-universitare, dar începuturile sunt foarte și foarte grele.
More than half of the interviewed migrant health professionals work below their qualifications, mostly in care, construction, or services. Around two-thirds of them send home regular remittances. The average amount is 324 euros per month. the consequences of health professionals' migration are now an important public policy concern, nationally and globally. As the international mobility of health professionals is now recognized as an inevitable characteristic of the health sector in the country, actions being undertaken in the Republic of Moldova aim to regulate the flow of health workers in order to aim to increase the mutual benefits for originating and destination countries, whilst recognizing the rights of mobility.
S-a observat că în numărul celor migrați este un număr înalt de lucrători medicali, în special medici. O bună parte se eliberau din instituțiile medicale și o bună parte din cei care absolveau nu se încadrau în activitate. Deci aceasta a făcut ca Republica Moldova să ridice această problemă la diferite forumuri internaționale, inclusiv a Organizației Mondiale a Sănătății, punând accent pe pierderea cadrelor medicale, fiindcă
what is needed is a greater collaboration with the international community, particularly with those destinations which are popular for Moldovan health professionals to migrate to, so that those who do choose to migrate in the destination countries receive the same benefits and rights as the national professionals and also have the ability to exercise the profession for which they are qualified.
Current policies related to migration, especially those undertaken by the countries of the European Union, focus on enhancing the mechanisms for legal migration and promoting circular migration, framed by the World Health Organization Code of Practice on International Recruitment of Health Personnel and by encouraging periodic work abroad with the intention to return home.
At the global level, WHO has an obligation to address the human resources for health challenges in many countries and apply the health system approach and move towards universal health coverage. To do it, the last decade, the Global Code of Practice for International Recruitment for Health Personnel was adopted.
There are a number of subjects or action lines in the code which are very relevant to the project in Moldova, such as create sustainable health workforce, including effective planning and education and health workforce retention, improving statistical data on migration flows, generating evidence on international migration and internal migration as well. Also facilitate circular migration of health professionals and engage member states in bilateral agreements.
To support the Republic of Moldova in addressing this challenge, the World Health Organization at regional and country levels, together with the European Union, implemented a project from 2012 to 2015 called Better Managing the Mobility of Health Professionals in the Republic of Moldova.
We have worked together with the WHO on the mobility of health care professionals, precisely with this idea that there would not be negative effects of brain drain, but that you would have circular mobility, people returning, going for certain times, getting that experience and coming back.
We have done many steps and have many results, but still much needs to be done as well in other European countries. And this needs a whole of government approach where different sectors like labor, finance, health, education need to be convened, public and private sector needs to be engaged, as well the local level needs to be reached where doctors and nurses are providing the services to those in need.
Due to migration, the Republic of Moldova, a country with limited resources after a 20-year transition period since it became an independent state, registers a net financial loss resulting from the costs associated with medical training and losses from missing of health workers in rural areas and some specialties.
În aceste condiții, atunci când țara nu are resurse suficiente, trebuie să fie foarte economă și să-și facă planuri bine croite, croite pe necesitățile atât a populației, bazate pe indicatorii de sănătate, dar și de asemenea pe capacitățile de pregătire a cadrelor medicale și nu ar trebui să producă permanent cadre medicale care de fapt dispar cum dispare apa în nisip, fiindcă aceasta este foarte scump.
As you know, Moldova is a source of health professionals and it was very, very important to find a framework for legal migration in order to mitigate negative impact of health professionals' mobility on health systems.
In 2013, 634 doctors graduated on the basis of budgetary resources. Ministry of Health data indicate that only 179 doctors and only 600 nurses from 1,200 graduates with secondary medical education have been employed. The Republic of Moldova invests budgetary resources and taxpayers' contributions in medical education. Costs range from 320,000 lei for a family doctor and approximately 400,000 lei for a surgeon with a narrow profile. Given the incomplete statistical data available about health professionals' migration, one of the project's basic activities focused on analyzing the situation in human resources for health. A number of studies on the migration of health professionals from the Republic of Moldova, carried out within the framework of the project, looked at migration trends, migration policies, working conditions, and types of employment gained in destination countries. An awareness campaign was conducted with the aim to raise the issue of health professional migration.
Am lansat până la momentul de față 4 studii. Am cercetat faptul ce se întâmplă cu persoanele care decid ca după ani lungi de studii, 9-11 ani și chiar ani de experiență, să-și părăsească profesia și să o înceapă de la zero cu o profesie nouă. De asemenea, ce se întâmplă cu cei care au migrat spre zone care i-au îmbrățișat mai cu drag, ca de exemplu România sau Italia și alte țări a Uniunii Europene.
Concluziile și evaluarea acestor studii au indicat foarte clar că în țara noastră există o necesitate stringentă de a elabora de urgență un proiect național al strategiei managementului resurselor umane în Republica Moldova.
The resulting recommendations and conclusions drew decision-makers' attention to the urgent need to develop a national strategy on human resources for health in the Republic of Moldova to strengthen capacities in health workforce planning and labor market analysis, and to improve employment policies and mechanisms for motivating and retaining health professionals. The Ministry of Health has started to work on these aspects with technical support from WHO.
Under this initiative, the evidence and information was gathered and shared. The database was created and all the doctors and nurses' information was entered to that database. Also, the framework for international agreements was developed and first agreement reached. The bottlenecks were also analyzed in terms of regulation, and the draft regulation was prepared. As well, the awareness was raised among the healthcare managers, they were trained. So there were many, many activities to mention under this initiative since 2011.
We are particularly proud that under the leadership of the Ministry of Health of Moldova, the project has taken what we call a comprehensive approach. So looking to this very complex issue from different angles. To assess the impact of migration, for example, the econometric study on costing the training of personnel, but also the retainment and the loss of input, in fact, how much it costs to the society, all this migration, but also other aspects, for example, the reasons why people are leaving the country or changing jobs, the medical profession inside the country. There were studies on what we call pull and push factors, but also to look, in fact, how do we, what are the mechanisms to retain the people, how to temper the migration.
Many national health systems have insufficient and poor quality data on human resources for health. For example, until recently, the Republic of Moldova had no centrally led, complete and up-to-date data on gender and age distribution of its health workers, reserve capacity, the number of specialists who have graduated from medical education institutions, or the real training needs among health workers.
Până la elaborarea și implementarea sistemului informațional, practic tot lucru ce ține de activitatea resurselor umane și de gestionarea cadrelor era făcut manual, pe hârtie, raportarea era făcută pe hârtie, arhivarea datelor de asemenea era pe suport de hârtie.
Baza de date a fost o lipsă pentru sistemul sănătății, de aceea o condiție a acestui proiect a fost elaborarea unui sistem informațional complex al creării bazei de date a personalului medical din țara noastră.
In this context, WHO contributed to improving and finalizing the information system on human resources for health evidence, an initiative supported initially by the International Organization for Migration. This database has been created to hold complete, accurate, and permanently updated information about health professionals in the health system. It creates an efficient mechanism for supporting planning of the health workforce and developing evidence-based policies in the health sector.
Deja au fost incluse în acest sistem informațional peste 30.000 de lucrători medicali, fie medici sau asistente medicale, și au fost instruiți peste 350 de lucrători al resurselor umane din instituțiile medicale în vederea stăpânirii acestui sistem informațional.
Trainingul a ținut o săptămână, în care în fiecare zi mi s-a explicat fiecare pas aparte, cum să lucrăm în el, cum să introducem toate datele corect pentru a beneficia de toate avantajele care ni le oferă acest sistem.
To offer guidance on how to enter, change and access employees' personal data, how to generate reports related to health professionals, the project has developed and published the Sierra's User's Guide, which has been provided to all specialists of HR divisions.
Această bază de date va servi la analiza tendinței de migrație a cadrelor medicale, va contribui la îmbunătățirea managementului, monitorizare și planificare cadrelor medicale în sănătate din Republica Moldova.
The employment, performance, motivation and retention of health workers is crucially influenced by policies related to the governance and management of human resources for health. With WHO support, the School of Public Health developed and implemented a course on governance and management of human resources for health for managers of health institutions and HR specialists. This has supported the development of managers' capacities and provided new tools to cope with the insufficiency of qualified personnel and uneven distribution between different geographical regions and different types of institutions.
Trainingul respectiv ne-a făcut îndeaproape cunoscuți cu acele politici internaționale și naționale care sunt la ziua de astăzi, vă zic, parte componentă a managementului resurselor umane.
Many of the health professionals who have left the country have faced difficulty in obtaining full recognition of their qualifications, and this remains a critical problem for doctors and nurses from the Republic of Moldova. Only 50% of doctors and 8% of nurses noted that their diploma was recognized in Italy after much effort, and 42% of doctors and 17% of nurses in other European Union countries. 28% of doctors passed additional exams and 14% were enrolled for 1 to 2 years of additional studies. Other European Union countries show a similar situation. Only 20% of the immigrant workers obtained a medical license to practice. Lack of effective integration in the labor market in the destination countries represents an important loss of their potential, as well as a loss of resources for both the originating and destination countries. WHO engaged many international experts to review and adapt post-university and secondary medical education programs in the Republic of Moldova to European and international requirements. To facilitate integration, a distance learning platform was developed in the State University of Medicine and Pharmacy Nicolae Testimițanu to support migrant health workers and those who have returned home.
Este normal ca după o întrerupere de mai mulți ani să fie necesară o reinstruire și atunci acești oameni ar putea să-și ia aceste cursuri de instruire, unele din ele la distanță, chiar aflându-se acolo în țara lor de destinație.
To support secular and legal migration, in 2013, the government of the Republic of Moldova approved the Intergovernmental Framework Agreement on Migration of Health Professionals and initiated negotiations with the destination countries with the highest migration flow. After several rounds of negotiation, the first Memorandum of Understanding in the area of health professionals' migration was signed in 2014 between the Republic of Moldova and the Federal Republic of Germany.
And this initiative in Moldova is really a translation of that global code to very practical solutions. And we are very grateful from WHO's side to have this opportunity and also for the resources provided by European Union to make this happen in past years.
Given the results and the achievements in the project, we would like to share now this huge source of information and policy recommendations with other countries in the region which are facing the similar issue of migration.
Moldova is the first country in European region where WHO has such a high level of engagement to work on human resources for health and address the questions of mobility and migration. Today we have the knowledge, the tools, as well the draft regulations to move forward. So I hope that if all the tools are applied, regulations are adopted, and the good practices put in place, then in 2020, when we come back, we see much more motivated doctors and nurses working in the healthcare facilities.